Abel, the first martyr. The word martyr signifies witness and is particularly used in reference to those who witness to the Lord's cause faithfully at the cost of suffering or death. Abel has the distinction of being God's first martyr. It is very remarkable that nearly all the martyrs have suffered at the hands of brethren. Thus, Jesus and the apostles received their persecution chiefly from Jewish brethren, sharers of the same blessed hopes and promises. How strange that it should be thus. Similarly, during this gospel age, Christians have suffered martyrdom at the hands of fellow Christians. Thus the scriptures foretold, saying, "Your brethren that hated you and that cast you out said, the Lord be glorified. But he shall appear to your joy, and they shall be ashamed." Every martyr, in proportion to his faithfulness, will ultimately receive a crown of life, while all persecutors will ultimately be ashamed. The reign of sin and death continued for 4,000 years before God sent his Son into the world to be its Redeemer and Deliverer. The Redeemer will set it free from bondage to sin and death, but he could not do so unless first he paid the death penalty, dying the just for the unjust. During those 4,000 years, vague promises were given from time to time, but no start was made to fulfill them until Jesus appeared. Even those vague promises were confined to the Jewish nation. Outside nations, the Gentiles, received no promises of relationship to God. They were condemned sinners, and no hopes were held out to them. As St. Paul says, they were without hope, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel, and strangers from the covenant of promise, having no hope, and without God in the world. For 6,000 years, according to St. Paul, we have had a reign of sin and death. Christians are still praying for the blessed day of Messiah, for Satan's binding. Then blessings will displace sin, sorrow, and death.